Hi everyone, today myself Tony will start NCLEX preparation part 2. Those who have not seen part 1, we have given the video's link in the description. So watch it part 1. Okay, so let's start part 2.
NCLEX RM preparation, multiple choice question type, part 2. Starting from the 6th question, the nurse is instructing a client with iron deficiency anemia. Which of the following meal plans would the nurse accept the client to select? So let's see the option. Option A, a roast beef, gelatin salad, green beans and pinch pie. Option B, chicken salad sandwich, coleslaw, french fries, ice cream. Option C, egg salad on wheat bread, carrot sticks, lettuce salad, raisin pie. Option D, pork chop, green potatoes, corn and coconut cake. Let's see the correct answer. So the correct answer is C, egg salad on wheat bread, carrot sticks, lettuce salad and raisin pie. Let's see why this is correct. Egg yolks, wheat bread, carrots, rice, and green leafed vegetable are all high in iron, which is an important mineral for this client. Roast beef, cabbage, and pork chops are also high in iron, but the side dishes accompanying these choices are not. Therefore, answer A, B, and D are incorrect. We have seen that the patient is suffering from iron deficiency anemia. So we have to give the patient a very good diet. So by that, he is suffering from iron deficiency can be recovered. So by that, we have to give egg salad on wheat bread, carrot sticks, lettuce salad and raisin pie. This is all green leafed vegetables and are very highly in iron, and by that client can be recovered soon. So option C is correct. For the 7th question, client with sickle cell anemia are taught to avoid activities that cause hypoxia and hypoxemia. Which of the following activities would the nurse recommend? Option A, a family vacation in a rocky mountain. Option B, championing the local boys club on the snow skiing trip. Option C, traveling by airplane for business trip. Option D, a bus trip to the Museum of Natural History. So let's see the correct answer. Correct answer is a bus trip to the Museum of Natural History. So let's see why this is correct. Taking a trip to the museum is the only answer that does not pose a threat. A family vacation is a rocky mountain at high altitudes, cold temperature and aeroplane travel can cause sickling episodes and should be avoided. Therefore answer A, B and C are correct. So we all know that the client is suffering from hypoxia and hypoxemia, and by that we should not take patient where there is chance of threat and all. By the patient having low amount of oxygen in blood, by that we should take them to a normal place or normal trip, and by this a bus trip to a museum of a natural history is correct. Further moving to the 8th question, the nurse is conducting an admission assessment of a client with vitamin B12 deficiency. Which finding reinforces the diagnosis of B12 deficiency? So let's see the option. Option A, enlarged spleen. Option B, elevated blood pressure. Option C, bradycardia. Your option D, bupivacaine. So let's see the correct answer. So the correct answer is D, bupivacaine. So let's see why this is correct. The tongue of a client with B12 insufficiency is red and beefy. Answer B, A and C is incorrect, because enlarged spleen, elevated BP and bradycardia are not associated with vitamin deficiency. So here we know that nurse doing assessment of patient which having vitamin B12 deficiency. In that, the tongue of a client is red and beefy, and by that option D is correct. Further moving to the 9th question, the body part that would most likely display jaundice in the dark skin individual is the option A, conjunctiva of eye. Option B, soles of a feet. Option C, roof of the mouth. Option D, sins. So let's see the correct answer. So the correct answer is C, roof of the mouth. So let's see why this is correct. The oral mucosa and hard palate are the best indicator of jaundice in dark skinned person. The conjunctiva can have normal deposit of fat which give a yellowish. Thus answer A is incorrect. The soles of a feet can be yellow if they are calloused, making answer B is incorrect. The shine would be an area of a darker pigment, so answer D is incorrect. So you have to know that the patient having jaundice in dark skinned person would suffer from the oral mucosa and hard palate in the roof of the mouth, and this is the best indicator of jaundice. So the correct answer is roof of the mouth. Answer conjunctiva can also be normal, but it give a yellowish, and so answer A is also incorrect. The sole of a feet can be yellow and calloused, so answer B also will be incorrect. And answer D, the shins would be area of a darker pigment, and here we are discussing about dark skin person, so option D is also incorrect. So correct option is C, roof of the mouth. Further going to the 10th question, the nurse is conducting a physical assessment on the client with anemia. Which of the following clinical manifestation would be most indicative of the anemia? Option A, BP 146/88. Option B, respiration 28 shallow. Option C, weight gain of 10 pounds in 6 months. Yeah, option D, pink complexion. So the correct option is option B, respiration 28 shallow. So let's see why this is correct. There are a few red blood cells. There is a less hemoglobin, less oxygen. Therefore, the client is often short of breath as indicated in answer B. The client with anemia is often pale in color, has weight loss and may be hypotensive. Answer A, C and D are within normal and therefore are correct. So you all know that the patient having anemia will having low blood and low oxygen, and by that he can be suffering short of breath is there in option B, and by this option B is correct. Normal manifestation of anemia is also there, A, C and D are also, but the most indicative anemia would be option B. So the correct option is respiration 28 shallow. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you all understand this lecture, and if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe our channel and share this video with your friends who are doing NCLEX exam preparation. We will back with another video. Till then, be happy, stay home, stay safe.